friends, I'm Vijayta from Martens Technologies. Today, we are going to learn about basic electronic components which are used in our daily lives. They store your money. They carry the sound of your voice into other people's homes. They bring airplanes into land and guides cars safely to their destination. They even fire off the airbags if you get into trouble. It's amazing to think just how many things they actually do. They are electrons, tiny particles within atoms. Try to think of something you do that doesn't involve electronics, and you may struggle. Electronics is all around us. Electronics is in entertainment, medical field, industry, and everywhere. Let us see what is electronics. Electronics deals with the development and application of devices and systems involving the flow of electrons in a vacuum, gas, and semiconductors. It is considered to be a branch of physics and electrical engineering. It also deals with electrical circuits that involve active electrical components such as transistors, diodes, integrated circuits, and associated passive electrical components. There are two types of electronic components. One is passive components and active components. Passive components are devices which stores energy in the form of voltage or current, or the components which cannot control the flow of current. Passive components cannot provide any power gain to the circuit. For example, resistors, capacitors, inductors, transformers. Active components. Active elements generate energy in the form of voltage or current. They supply energy to the circuit and they can control the flow of current. Also, they can provide power gain to the circuit. For example, transistors, triode, vacuum tubes, voltage sources. Next, we will see about what is a circuit and its types. Circuit. Circuit can be electrical, electronic, analog, digital, synchronous, asynchronous, etc. Electrical circuit. A complete electrical network with a closed loop giving a return path for current. Electronic circuit. It is a combination of electronic components capable of performing amplification, computation, and data transfer. Analog circuit uses continuous and digital circuit uses discrete signal levels respectively. The two types of circuits are series circuits and parallel circuit. Series circuit. Components are wired one after another. Electricity will pass through first component, then the next component, then the next, and so on. In a series circuit, the current through each of the components is the same, and the voltage across the circuit is the sum of the voltages across each component. Parallel circuit. Components are wired side by side. Electricity passes through all of them at the same time, from one common point to another common point. In a parallel circuit, the voltage across each of the components is the same, and the total current is the sum of the currents through each component. Now let us see what is closed circuit and open circuit. Closed circuit. A complete electrical circuit through which current can flow when a voltage is applied. A closed circuit will allow the flow of electricity between power and ground. It is used when requiring the use of current. Open circuit. An incomplete electrical circuit in which no current flows. An open circuit will break the flow of electricity between power and ground. Let's see about current. Current is the movement or flow of electric charge, or continuous and uniform flow of charge around the circuit. According to Ohm's law, current is given by I is equal to V divided by R. That is, current is equal to voltage divided by resistance. It is measured in units of amperes. There are two types of current. Alternating current and direct current. Alternating current. In AC, the direction of electricity flowing throughout the circuit is constantly reversing. AC is obtained from alternators. It can be transmitted over long distance with some losses. For example, current flowing in power lines or normal household electricity that comes from a wall outlet. Direct current. In DC, the flow of electric charge is unidirectional. DC is obtained from generators, battery, solar cell, etc. It can be transmitted over very long distance with negligible losses. It is used to charge batteries, cell phones, flat screen TVs, flashlights, etc. What is voltage? Voltage is the difference in electric potential between two points. According to Ohm's law, voltage is given by V is equal to I into R. That is, voltage is equal to the product of current and resistance. It is measured in units of volts. Now, let us see about electronic components. Resistor. Resistors add resistance to the circuit and reduce the flow of electrical current. If too much current flows through an LED, it is destroyed. So, a resistor is used to limit the current. The different markings on the resistor represent different values of resistance. The values are read from left to right towards the gold band. The first two colors represent the resistor value, the third represents the multiplier, and the fourth represents the tolerance. This is the resistance color code. For example, this resistor has brown, black, brown color. So, the resistance will be 100 ohm. That is, the first band is 1, the second band is 0, and the multiplier is 10. So, the resistance will be 100 ohm. Resistance. Resistance is the opposition to the flow of current or measure of difficulty to pass an electrical current through conductor. According to Ohm's law, resistance is given by R is equal to V by I. That is, resistance is equal to voltage divided by current. It is measured in units of ohms. Conductors have very little resistance and insulators have large amount of resistance. Capacitor. Capacitor stores potential energy in an electric field. The amount of electrical energy a capacitor can store is called as capacitance. The capacitance is given by C is equal to Q divided by V. That is, capacitance is equal to charge divided by voltage. Capacitors are measured in farad. The common capacitors are ceramic disc and electrolytic. Capacitors can smooth out a signal, eliminate the ripples or spikes in DC voltage. Capacitors are used in energy storage, sensing, wattmeter, timing devices, etc. Inductor. Inductor temporarily stores the electrical energy in the form of a magnetic field. It consists of coil of copper wire. When the electric current is passed through the coil, the magnetic field is produced and stored in the coil of copper wires. It is used in filters, sensors, transformers, motors, etc. Transistor. Transistor is a semiconductor device used to amplify or switch electronic signals and electrical power. Transistors have three pins, that is, collector, emitter, and base. The basic type of transistors are PNP and NPN. PNP transistors allow electricity to pass from emitter to collector pin. NPN transistors allow electricity to pass from collector to emitter pin. Transistors are used as simple switches, voltage and power amplifiers, etc. Diodes. They allow electrical current to pass through them in only one direction. A diode has low resistance in one direction and high resistance in the other direction. The type of diodes are crystal diodes, gun diodes, light emitting diodes, laser diodes, Zener diodes, etc. Diodes are used in radio demodulation, power conversion, logic gates, temperature measurements, etc. LED. LED stands for light emitting diode. A special type of diode that lights up when electricity passes through it. Color of the light is determined by energy band gap of the semiconductor. LEDs are used in automotive headlamps, advertising, traffic signals, and camera flashes, etc. LEDs are widely used because of lower energy consumption, longer lifetime, smaller size, and faster switching. Switch. Switch is an electrical component that can make or break an electrical circuit. The mechanism of a switch removes or restores the conducting path in a circuit when it is operated. Switches are the safest way to stop or start the flow of electricity in a device. Example for electronic switches, relay, analog switch, etc. Switches are used for on or off control, user input, etc. Switches can be of mechanical or electronic type. Mechanical switches. Mechanical switches must be activated physically by moving, pressing, releasing, or touching its contacts. The type of mechanical switches are single pole single throw, single pole double throw, double pole single throw, double pole double throw, etc. Electronic switches. Electronic switches do not require any physical contact in order to control a circuit. These are activated by semiconductor action. The type of electronic switches are bipolar transistors, power diode, MOSFET, etc. Relay. Relay is an electrically operated switch. Relays are used where a circuit is controlled by a low power signal or where several circuits must be controlled by one signal. Sometimes, the amount of electricity flowing in a device is so high that it is dangerous to humans. To protect people, relays can be put into a device to turn on and off special functions. The relay takes very little electricity to make it turn on and off a device with lots more electricity. It is used in motor control, electrical fuel pumps, industrial applications, etc. Battery. Batteries convert chemical energy directly to electrical energy. The chemical reaction inside of the batteries separates positive charges from negative charges and puts each one at one end of the battery or cell. When a battery is supplying electric power, its positive terminal is the cathode and its negative terminal is the anode. Batteries and cells are power sources. Motor. An electrical machine that converts electrical energy into mechanical energy. It turns electrical energy into motion, usually rotation. The types of motors are AC motor, DC motor. The principle of working of a DC motor is that whenever a current carrying conductor is placed in a magnetic field, it experiences a mechanical force. Amplifier. An electronic device that can increase the power of a signal. It uses electric power to increase the amplitude of the signal. It has power gain greater than 1. Amplifiers are used in wireless communications and broadcasting and in audio equipment, etc. Rectifier. A rectifier is an electrical device that converts alternating current to direct current. The process of converting alternating current to direct current is also called as rectification. Rectifiers are used as components of power supplies and as detectors of radio signals, etc. The type of rectifiers are half-wave rectifier, full-wave rectifier. Half-wave rectifier is a type of rectifier which converts the positive half cycle of the input signal into pulsating DC output signal. Full wave rectifier is a type of rectifier which converts both half cycle of the AC signal into pulsating DC signal. Potentiometers. Potentiometers are variable resistors. Potentiometers have three legs as to create a voltage divider, which are basically two resistors in series. It is used for measuring electric potential and used to control electrical devices. Potentiometers are measured in homes. Applications of potentiometers are audio control, television, motion control, etc. Integrated circuits. A set of electronic circuits on one small flat piece of semiconductor material, normally silicon. Mass production capability, reliability, and building block approach to circuit design has ensured the rapid adoption of ICs in place of using discrete transistors. ICs are smaller, cheaper, and faster. ICs are used in computers, mobile phones, digital home appliances, etc. So friends, we have seen basic electronic components which are used in our daily lives. When I say this, you'll be having a question like, why I need to learn about the basic electronic components? As I said earlier, you'll be using these components in daily life. So, if you learn about these things, you can create or invent new things. Otherwise, you'll be stick with being a user. Thanks for watching.